Hello, everyone, and welcome to another General Zero Hour replay. This is Scottagorn.
And Tytan.
And Tytan, today we have a replay from October 30th of 2021, and this is a 4v4 on Swamp Matrix map. What makes this map a little bit different from what we usually do?
Well, for this time, when we set up our teams, we had one team set up in the four corners, as far away from each other as possible, and the other team set up in the middle. When they've done it before, they've always tried to split the map 50-50 however they could. But we decided to try to split it up a little bit this time.
I remember Shifty saying this was an inside and outside map, and I remember saying, I don't think so, before starting the game, and we did it anyways.
Yeah.
Outside would be myself, Pcap, top left Pancake, and bottom left Tytan. Inside, Ed. On the left side, Skippy. Up top, Shifty. And Coredawg, making the interior team. So, our team's plan right away, what we said, was for me and you, Tytan, to go after Ed.
Yeah, I felt like we were kind of trying to get to it as fast as we could, but I didn't want to just rush in there and be, you know, undefended ourselves. So,
yeah, and I'm trying to rush with a couple infantry. You can see that guy running up against the bulldozer. He's not going to be of any help whatsoever. Also trying to get the fire bases out of range of that Gatling cannon. Didn't do that either. And so, one is firing on the Gatling cannon, but Ed's got a good defense against myself right now. He's got a defense set up on your side. Looks like you're consolidating things, getting the second supply up.
Yep.
The problem is Coredawg and Shifty also had a plan to team up on one player, and that player is Pcap.
Yeah, they took it to him as soon as they could, and they did an amazing job. They just busted through before he had any defenses up.
No defenses. The two barracks up from Coredawg already, up top. Shifty bringing in a Humvee, taking out the Chinooks for Pcap.
Yeah, I remember Pcap just starting to panic at this point.
Yes, I believe his words were, well, I'm getting double teamed and my base is getting destroyed, so I hope you guys are doing something with your lives. So, pretty much saying, I'm taking over the team, earn this one. He knew the plan, he knew our plan was to take out Ed, and that their plan was to take out him, so he was hoping we were at least trading bases with them.
Yeah, I think Pancake was trying to make up for that, but he was focused somewhere where he shouldn't be at that point. Skippy came up from behind, snuck a technical in, and started sniping his workers.
Yes, very early on. There goes the last worker, and that's the last one. Pancake, I don't think he noticed it. I don't think he knew it was there.
Yeah.
Because he does not replenish those workers this game. That's the last that he collects from that supply.
Yeah, I think he got too nervous trying to help Pcap out. Because he starts making his own course to try to take Shifty out. But
one bulldozer left for Pcap.
Yep.
Over on this right side. That Coredawg doesn't see or doesn't notice or isn't focused on right now. And that's all he's got left down here. Okay. No new cannon yet, but Ed will be bringing one in real soon. And I'm actually going to have trouble down there with Ed's new cannon as well, so not holding up my end of the bargain.
Nope, they had a very solid plan, that middle team, right at the beginning. There, we can see that Skippy is starting to bring in his team to try to take on Pancake. Pancake decided to take his force around into the backside of Shifty's base to try to hit him from behind while he was focused somewhere else as well. Loading massive force there.
Five technicals. Decided not to engage with Skippy's troops instead, maybe going for the base trade instead, knowing that Skippy's quad cannons would be stronger against his technicals and infantry.
Yeah, they would have cut them to pieces.
Right, but now, Skippy's moving into his base. Got some scorpion tanks trying to help out.
I think he had the rally point set a little farther down, right, so that scorpion didn't engage with those quad cannons when it should have.
Yep. So, Pancake does get a few buildings here, but up at the top right side, the deed is done. Pcap,
basically
luckily did not give up, because he was talking about it. He asked the group, should I just surrender and call it good? Coredawg now bringing in a bunch of Humvees to try to help out. He did manage to get one scaffold up with that bulldozer before they took out his last building, and this might have been the scaffold that kept him in the game. That one bulldozer was able to escape, and Pcap lives to see another day, but he's going to have to rebuild his base from scratch.
Basically out of the game for all intents and purposes at this point.
Coredawg bringing even more Humvees and some more Rangers. Going to be able to clear out the rest of these infantry here. Meanwhile, Skippy's doing a great job in Pancake space. Pancake, again, without the money to be able to create any more units to stop him.
No recourse at all, unless he just wants to sell everything, and then he would be left with nothing.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it's about this point that Shifty is rebuilding in Pcap's old base.
And recapturing his buildings down here. We're going to try to, but that forces Pancake to sell, which is fortunate that he did, because that takes those buildings away from Shifty, but at the same time, leaves him with very little left. It's a little bit of money, but can't really do anything with it.
Yep.
And this is Pancake's last building. There it goes.
Yep.
What are we? It's 6 minutes into the game, and we are now down almost two players.
It is essentially a 2v4 at this point in time, extremely early in the game.
Pcap has the command center and one reactor. Coredawg's base intact, looking strong. Good defenses. Shifty does still hold on to his supply here, his barracks, and one fire base, Skippy's base. Looking strong with some defenses.
And a nice force up top, too.
It looks like you were pushing in on Ed's base, actually, doing okay on your side. So you've got some hope there.
Yep.
Doing better than I was. I did not have a good start to this game. I've got three Humvees sitting there that I just knew. I was convinced those Humvees were going to get bombed by some plane coming over the top. At any point in time, I was just ready to lose all those guys. I do have an airfield up. Somewhere around here.
I think it's glitching right now. It is there, and you can see the aurora.
Oh, yeah, units. I see it. Yeah, I see the aurora on it. But down 2v4, I was convinced we were going to lose.
Yeah.
Pcap barely held on. But I had, at some point in time, I realized, I'm super weapon. I've got auroras. We've got a puncher's chance here. We've got just a slight chance that something could happen. So it's like at this point, you're looking out over the barren wasteland of what's in front of you, knowing you're probably going to lose. But it's like, okay, let's do it. Megatron must be stopped, no matter the cost. You got the touch. You got the power. That's all I want. All I want is a chance. After all is said and done, you never walk, you never run, you're a winner.
Hit him from one side, I hit him from the other. Hammer and anvil strategy.
That's right. Which is what it was supposed to be at the beginning of the game. Finally coming to fruition. You're at your best when the going gets
rough. You've been put to the test, but it's never enough. I'm Duke, so if I had just sent them right in, they would have just blown each other up.
That's right.
I had to wait for the propaganda center. When all hell's breaking loose, you'll be right in the eye of the storm. You got the heart. Here comes Skippy into my base with that team that he took out Pancake with.
Ed has been defeated.
Took him out.
Hope is in.
Coredawg
glad that you were able to attack and defend at the same time this game. Yes, trying to find a way to Coredawg's base, but I know his laser cannons are there.
Instead of engaging and losing troops, you just nuke them.
Yes.
Which works out quite well.
I found a way in.
And then Skippy's got another bird down trying to get into my base again. I should be making my defenses there, trying to get ready for it. You're hidden in the Coredawg's base.
Bringing in the Auroras, bringing in the Humvees.
Nice. You're at your best when the going gets rough. You've been put to the test.
You got the power! Yeah! There you are, join me for the fun. Laser turrets are no longer in the way, just have some infantry to take out.
Since I am trying to get to have that radiation with my tanks attack, so they take out infantry extremely well. Have a propaganda center on top of that overlord, so it continually heals.
Yes. Yes, and heals the tanks around it as well.
Yes.
Also useful. Here I'm bringing the missile defenders out of my Humvee.
Yep.
Okay.
And Skippy is starting to get his force ready to bring into my base.
Uh-huh, I see that.
I think I can just see, and there, Coredawg's been defeated.
Coredawg's been defeated. There he is.
He gave up and went to... gave all of this stuff to Shifty. So, but,
they're down the south side.
Yep, he's starting to try to hit me a little bit. I think this is about the time, yep, I get a new cannon set up.
That's the one that makes a big difference.
yeah, it does.
Just having one new cannon on defense behind a line of defenses can make all the world a difference.
Yep.
Here goes three RPG troopers.
Luckily for me, he had parked his people a little too close.
Sure,
I could
still
see him with those quad cannons, so
one buggy.
I knew he was coming.
One buggy took that one out.
Yep. He knew he was getting nukes, so he tried pushing too early.
Yeah, you've got the defenses, you've got the overlords, you've got the new cannon behind.
Yep.
That is...
he demonstrative.
Yes. The nice force still left over, too.
You're just cleaning it up.
Cleaning up some units here. Just cleaning up some old laser turrets.
I think Shifty is also sending out some air units.
Yeah, he's trying to just take on PCAP's supply down here, actually.
Oh.
Because PCAP is starting to rebuild. PCAP is getting ready to rejoin the fight here. He's got the supply, and he's got some Humvees going. So, he also actually helped defend my base. Coredawg had some extra rangers sitting around and from all the destroyed buildings. And so, Pcap helped to keep those off of me.
Nice. I've got my nuclear missile up and going, finally.
Yeah.
So.
Do you upgrade those tanks with it?
They come pre-upgraded since I'm nuke.
Wow, yes.
Yeah. But... yep, Skippy's still trying to find a way into my base, and I'm still stopping him at the door. So...
yeah, looks like the tide has turned over on your side. PCAP's rebuilding on our side. This is starting to look actually in our favor.
Yep.
Somehow.
I start trying to push towards Skippy. See if I can start working my way in his direction. but of course he's got a very solid defense. Very solid. Like, he's got the bunkers there on the side.
He's been working on it all game.
Yep.
Lots of RPG troopers coming out of there.
And you're just systematically working on it.
Trying to find something effective to do now. I have one Humvee left from all of that, but he's triple promoted. I decide to just micro one Humvee unit instead of trying to macro and do a whole bunch else with my base. They have done hardly any base building at this point in time. But luckily, even though my base isn't that well built up, Pcap's ready to join the fight again.
Yep.
Which makes him our third attacker, which means this kind of turned from a 4v2 to a 3v2 the other way. You're over here working on Skippy's
He had a little supply unit there. Yep. I don't want to get too close, because they'll annihilate me if I get too close to them.
Pcap trying to find his way through the base here. Shifty does have the right units to keep those Humvees at bay, Paladins and the Avengers.
Yeah.
That's a good combo.
But Pcap has a lot of experience with those Humvees. He can get very annoying with them.
Yes. I think he's been doing that longer in the group than anyone else.
Yeah.
Found Shifty's supply there.
And then he's found the other one.
Yep.
So. Still see if your auroras are flying.
Yeah.
You said you had those hotkeyed, right? So you're micromanaging both of them.
Yes. Yep. I'm running the Humvees around while working on these auroras. Now all very nicely promoted. Yeah. And Shifty's defense. What is he left up here? A whole bunch of Rangers and a bulldozer.
Yeah. Skippy is starting to get a few more buggies and stuff and trying to take me out, because I've been blasting him with new cannons for a while. He did not like that.
Okay. You were working on his defenses. Whoa!
Yep, one new cannon one took new the entire thing out.
He got both of them.
He did. It was good enough trade for him, I think.
Yeah, that's really going to add up.
But here pretty soon, I feel like I've got enough of a force. I just try to punch my way through, no matter the cost. Yep. I just want to see who can get through there, because I don't want to spend my entire time just losing my forces trying to hit the front wall, so I just mow over them.
Right, at some point in time you figure even if I bring in another new cannon, he might pick it off the buggies anyways.
Yep, kind of at a stalemate. I just wanted to get things moving.
Here's where I lose all my auroras. Yep, one Avenger got out of his war factory right on time.
I think it's... Yep, it is now.
So a Gatling cannon on that Overlord, and so... Okay, so you're not even stopping for those units.
I literally put them into the middle of his base.
Overlords do run over tanks and everything else, so...
And since I'm new, they get destroyed and blow up stuff around them.
Yes.
So that literally took out his defenses as I was going.
Right.
And now he's got nothing in his base to stop me.
Oof.
Yep.
That was a lot of tank sacrifice.
It was.
Do have two tanks left in an unprotected base.
And he's got nothing to stop me.
That was it. It was all defense. You got two in there.
And I do still have those other units up there, but I'll be bringing them down later.
That's right, that small group from Coredawg. Yep. Coredawg.
Kind of forgotten for right now.
Shifty is chasing Pcap all over the board. I noticed Pcap just ran his Humvees away. Pretty much distracting Shifty.
Yeah.
Your units away, that's where you...
Yep, I nuked his base and I knew that was coming, so I got my units out of there and brought them right back in.
Yeah. That group of RPG troopers would be trouble for regular China tanks in that way, but cleaned up pretty quickly.
Because of the nukes. Yeah. That radiation that gets left over really does help against the infantry. And then there comes the other ones that I had forgotten up there.
Down.
Yep. Right across there.
Coming across the bridge.
Yep. So now I have two overlords, three battlemasters, and a nuke cannon in the backside of his base.
Nicely done.
You guys, oh my gosh, you've got a nice army of Humvees coming up.
Yep. It was finally at this point in the game where I realized that I thought we were going to win. The whole time. The whole time until then, I still thought we were either even or we're going to lose up until this. But at this point in time, driving all these Humvees up, I remember saying, brethren, I believe we may have just pulled this off. Yep, you are in Skippy's base.
Yep.
Cleaning things up.
Just staying away from the corners, because he has a very nice defense.
He still has defenses all the way around the sides.
Yep.
The bunkers are still full. I was waiting for a little paratrooper drop, just to be fodder. But I think they got flashbanged immediately.
And sniped. Yep. He's got a lot of pathfinders there as well. Yeah. Did you do something to, like, get rid of the power? Like,
that would have been General's Promotions over the top, I believe.
Okay.
Also, over here, Pcap had sent in some reinforcements and retaken this corner area, which Shifty had taken from him. Which was fortunate, because Shifty having to do all that in the corner actually distracted him while we were working on Ed and Coredawg's base. Just delayed him slightly enough.
Very nice. Shifty gave up, he's done.
Yep.
You guys just start kind of cleaning up there.
Just us and Skippy now.
I'm trying to just kind of clean up what I can around there, because I don't know exactly where his last buildings are, and he's got a few.
Yep. Bringing in more nuke cannons again.
Yeah. I like nuke cannons.
Oh, yeah. I mean, if there's not any buggies around to take them out.
Yeah.
I mean, look what happens to a tank when, when you don't have a new cannon to take care of the garrisons.
Yeah, it looks like you guys got everything mopped up in the top corner.
Yeah, coming your direction.
Yep,
Pancake,
just to help out.
Pancake was still with us this whole time. I mean, he's not in the game. But I was asking him, okay, where's the next building, Pancake? Right? He was directing me from place to place. Here comes Pcap. Everyone's together. Everyone's here for the party now. And, these are the last ones. The last buildings from Skippy, I believe.
Mm-hmm. Oh, the artillery barrage. Yeah. That kind of helps take that out. And I think this is about the point that Skippy's just done.
Yep, there's not much left to do.
No.
After all that carnage, there's only two bases left. Bottom right corner, where Pcap rebuilt really well.
Oh,
and then bottom left for yourself.
And that does it. Yep.
You are victorious.
The comeback.
From behind victory.
Which we don't see very often.
I don't think we've ever seen that. Like, as soon as...
One of the things that makes this game so special.
Yeah. Usually as soon as one player gets taken out, it's just a domino effect.
So my thought originally was that the interior team would have the benefit going into the game because they're all grouped together. But the thing that was in our favor there is when we did lose two players, they couldn't just keep on rolling through our bases. Mine and your bases were on the other sides of the map, and so they were segmented off. Whereas when we rolled through their bases were all pretty well together.
Yep, they did not fortify or put any kind of defenses on the back side of their base. And so as soon as, like, we got that domino effect,
yep.
As soon as we took out Ed, it was just systematic from there.
Yep. Fun game. Very, very fun game. Very satisfying game. Looking at, actually, Pcap, even though he was taken out early, ended up doing a whole bunch of rebuilding in my base, and was it good for insurance just in case Shifty was able to take one of us out with a super weapon or something. Pcap was rebuilding, so that was good insurance for us with all that money. Buildings destroyed, myself and you, 38 and 20 between us.
No, Nice.
Good proportion of the buildings. That might have something to do with why we're the ones doing this replay right now. It was a fun game for us.
Yeah.
But other categories, units created. That one goes to Skippy, far and away. Lots of RPG 45. Troopers keeping you out of there, filling up those bunkers.
Uh-huh.
And next to him, really no one touches that. I mean, Pcap's the next closest one, 88, but still, Skippy far and ahead. The most units created.
Yeah.
Units destroyed, again, yourself and myself.
Yeah.
One of the reasons it was such a fun game. Anything else from this one? Anything else you remember?
Oh, no. I remember the chatter on the headset, but I just had to focus on what I was doing. I couldn't think of anything else going on around me. I just had to focus on my base and nothing else.
Right.
Because, like you said, we were so segmented, we felt like we were just kind of like little islands. Mm-hmm. If we didn't focus on ourselves, there isn't much we can do.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Agreed. That was a fun one. That was a fun replay.
Yeah. It was amazing in the beginning how Coredawg, Shifty, and
Skippy,
they just, it should have gone to them.
It should have.
All things considered, they did an amazing job. Ed did a great job with his defenses,
yep,
holding us off at first, letting his other three teammates go up and destroy those top two bases. This should not have happened.
Yep.
It should not have gone this way at all.
I feel like there was one way to win that game, and we found it somehow.
Yep.
But you're right, their team did their jobs really well as well, so.
Yeah.
It's kind of a good game all around.
Yeah. It was amazing on all sides.
Yep.
So.
Anything else on that one, Tytan?
That's all I've got.
All right. Till next time, everyone. Thanks for watching.